And this is a very simple case where the patient came in, she had sensitivity, and it's because of some enamel chipping around the incisal edge. So basically not a fancy case, just a routine composite resin case. Just noticed that I put a little tiny drop of flowable on and cured it with the bonding agent, and then I've gone back and put a little bit more flowable, left it wet, all uncured, and now I'm injecting composite resin. And you'll notice that I was able to basically do a monolithic restoration. So we're doing all of the composite in a single piece. Everywhere you have joins in composite resin, you're at risk of stains. So we really want it seamless. Okay, we want a seamless restoration. So we're not trying to, there's no point doing multiple layers and stuff on a case like this, because you'll just end up with seams between the layers and you'll get a lot more staining, and it will look great for the first month, and then after a year it'll look worse. So notice on the adjacent composite resins, where the composite resins are seamless, there's no stains. It's only where there's a join or a weak sort of margin. Now, when in the past I haven't used air abrasion, so it's quite likely a lot of the time that the tooth had plaque on the remaining tooth structure. So nothing fancy here, not trying to get the shape too right. I'm just trying to fix the excess on the back of the tooth, because the back of the tooth is hard to trim if there's a lot of excess there. And get the height roughly the same, and everything else I'm going to fix with the burrs. So cure. So they're basically a monoblock of composite. So take everything out. And then, because this restoration is basically right near the gingiva, I can't do the trimming. I can't do much of the trimming with the rubber dam on. So, but I can get the incisal edge correct. So basically we're just running the disc from one tooth to the next. And there we go. It's a finished restoration. Seamless. No joins where it can stay. Thank you.